There is a lot of cool stuff that happens in the world of FOSS, but for whatever reason, I personally find a lot of enjoyment seeing stuff happening in the world of open source GPU drivers. Just the fact that there are people that go out of their way to reverse engineer GPU drivers, and the result they get in some cases, you know, maybe it's not great, but in others, actually good or better than what is being provided by the company themselves. And then we have cases where the company is directly involved in the open source project. They actually respect the open source community and make it so people who want to get involved in this actually can. Now, sure, you might argue, and I've argued this before, that a lot of companies like open source because, you know, you don't have to pay people to do some work. But look, interests can align, right? The company gets something out of it, I can get something out of it. It's a win-win. And a lot of this work lives in the Mesa project. And with the release of Mesa 25.1, I could have done two separate videos about this, but I feel like they kind of belong together. So let's start with the one that I got an email about. Goodbye, NovoGL. Hello, Zinc. So NovoGL, or Novo OpenGL, is the way the open source Nvidia drivers were doing OpenGL support. Now, the open source Nvidia drivers, that being Novo, not the new ones, NVK being worked on by Red Hat people, in the past, were in a pretty good state. For a while, because there was stuff moved from the driver into the firmware, not a great state, along with not having great Vulkan support. Nowadays, though, at least on the newer GPUs, yes, it's not perfect, but we're actually seeing a world where you can have an open source Nvidia stack. But starting with Mesa 25.1, Novo users will no longer get the old Novo OpenGL driver by default, and will instead get Zinc plus NVK. NVK, for anyone who hasn't seen my prior videos on it or just generally heard about it, is Nvidia Vulkan. It is the Vulkan support for these open source Nvidia drivers. And Vulkan is incredibly important on Linux because this is the primary way that we do gaming. Yes, there are things made in OpenGL, but if you're going with Proton, Proton is something known as DXVK. This is DirectX to Vulkan. This is the way that we play games primarily on Linux. So if you don't have that Vulkan support, you know, there's a problem there. Now, I know there are some projects that aim to do workarounds to that and make things work on older cards, but having Vulkan support there is basically the streamlined approach to get this done. As for Zinc, this is also a really cool tech, and at least from what I can tell, makes things quite a bit easier. So, like how Proton is DirectX to Vulkan, Zinc is Vulkan to OpenGL. So you don't have to have direct OpenGL drivers, you can build everything off the existing Vulkan work. Now, annoyingly, as a recording, the free desktop GitLab is going through an architecture migration, so it's currently down. But at least we have an archive of the merge request where this was added. Loader, Novo, load Zinc as the GL driver for Turing and above. If the kernel supports modifiers and the GPU is Turing Plus, then force Zinc instead of NVC0. Turing, for anyone who's forgotten, is from 2018. This is the 20 series or newer cards, which I know a lot of people still have older cards, but yes, those are going to be 7-year-old GPUs this year. I know. Feel old. Zinc has matured a lot since the initial blog post in 2018. It has grown to support OpenGL 4.6 and is a conformant implementation on top of multiple hardware drivers. It's also improved significantly in performance and stability over the last few years. At this point, we're fairly confident that Zinc plus NVK will be an improvement over NovoGL across the board. Compatibility layers are fairly common in graphics. Around 10 years ago, Keith Packard developed Glamour, which implements X-rendering in OpenGL. Glamour combined with mode setting driver has allowed us to delete nearly all hardware-specific X11 backends, and X11 now uses the same kernel and user space APIs as a Wayland compositor. As I mentioned before, DXVK in the gaming space also is a compatibility layer. This has allowed driver teams to focus on the OpenGL and Vulkan drivers and stop worrying about X rendering. Microsoft has done similar things with Direct3D. No hardware vendor has shipped a hardware D3D8 driver in a long time, that being DirectX 8, and they've released layers implementing DirectX 9 and DirectX 11 on top of DirectX 12, paving the way for hardware vendors to drop everything before DirectX 12 entirely. Often it takes some time before the switch over to a compatibility layer is complete. The old drivers are battle-tested, and the fear is always the compatibility layer may introduce performance regressions or application issues. This is true in cases where the driver is good. Part of what makes Novo a good trailblazer here is the old NovoGL driver is actually pretty bad. So don't be worse than the hardware driver isn't as high a bar for us as for other drivers. NVK, on the other hand, is proven to be pretty solid, and Zinc plus NVK seems to be working well. Basically, don't be worse than garbage, and you'll be fine. That is certainly a lot more achievable than what you see from, say, a lot of the Rust rewrites in the Linux kernel, right? You're going from a driver, which is battle-tested, good C code, it works, it does what it needs to do, to a new driver where it's gonna have different bugs, new bugs, it might not have the same class of bugs, but it's just less overall tested. But if you're going from a driver that sucks, just try something new. Now, so far, we've been talking about OpenGL and Vulkan thanks to Zinc. But OpenGL isn't the only thing that you want your GPU to be able to do. And it isn't the only thing under the banner of the Kronos Group. Something else you might want is GPU compute with OpenCL. Now, obviously, OpenCL has a lot of competition and there's a lot of work that isn't done with OpenCL, but OpenCL is often an option there when you're not doing things with an NVIDIA GPU. Now, OpenCL isn't being done through Zinc. This is a whole separate thing, but there is news on OpenCL as well. In the past, Mesa's had an OpenCL driver known as Clover. Much like the NovoGL driver from before, it didn't exactly have the best of reputations. As some put it, Clover was practically useless. So, when something better comes along, replacing the old driver isn't exactly a... Well, it's a big effort, sure. But again, it's not replacing something which is well-beloved and works really well. Luckily for us, though, for quite a while now, a new driver has been a work in progress. That driver called Rusticle or Rusty CL? I don't think there's actually an official pronunciation of how to say it. As one might expect from the Rusty part, this is a Rust rewrite of an OpenCL driver. I believe that I have talked about it on the channel before. I don't remember. Back when I would have talked about it, I believe this was happening. Mesa developers are removing Clover once RustyCL OpenCL code hits parity. But that was a few years back, and now a few days ago, alongside Mesa 25.1, RustyCL wins, Mesa officially deprecates the Clover OpenCL. At this stage saying that Clover is going to be removed in Mesa 25.2, which is set for sometime around Q3 2025. It's possible there's still going to be pieces of the code that stick around a bit longer than that, but right now, it being deprecated, you should be, if you were already using it, migrating off of that driver over to the new RustyCL. It's not even new at this point, but newly made the absolute default. It is always fun to check in on the world of GPUs, because, as I said, I just think it's cool that we have open source GPU drivers. Just that fact by itself, even if they're not in the perfect state, I don't know. I just like it. What are your thoughts? Let me know down below. Do any of the things I mentioned today affect you? Did you just watch it because you wanted some background noise? I'd love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. If you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe, Silly Bear Pay, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and Rusty.
What is this?